现在收看的是华视教育文化频道，
接下来要播出的是英语口语训练二。
Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Conversational English Book 2, Lesson 2. Today we continue with the interior design company that the Hudsons, Ed and Betty, have together. And they're going to set up a meeting today. Let's take a look at our preview material.Lesson 2 gives good examples of how a telephone call should be made and how to conduct oneself at a sales meeting. The best way to understand that is to listen to Lori as she translates that for us and explains it.
Thank you. 好，所以呢，我们今天呢，第二课要来学到的，其实是在公司里面很重要的一个用电话来联络事情以及一些基本的电话礼仪。所以，我们赶快跟着 Bruce 老师一起来看看我们今天的这个短句。
That's right. Let's take a look now at dialogue two, lesson two, dialogue for the first time.
Chen, may I help you?
I'd like to speak with Alice Chen, please.
Speaking.
Good morning. I'm Betty Hudson at Sublime Interiors. We received your email and we'd like to invite you to show your new line of curtain materials. What time would be convenient for you?
I'm available this afternoon or tomorrow morning, if that's convenient for you.
This afternoon would be better.We have a meeting here tomorrow morning.
How about 3 o'clock? I already have all the materials you mentioned ready to show.
That would be great. Then we'll see you at 3 o'clock. Your company has our address and contact phone numbers, but I can send them to you again if you like.
That's not necessary. We're on your supply interiors. I will see you at 3.
Bye.
Bye.Materials is ready for Dai Chen. Oh. Is Miss Hudson here?
I am Betty Hudson.
Oh,
and call me Betty.
And please call me Alice.
Okay, we are already in the meeting room. Please follow me. And let me help you with your samples.
Thanks, Betty.
Here. Allow me to introduce Alice Chen to you all. Okay. This is Ed Hudson, our company boss. Next to him is George Hong, our sales supervisor. And next to him is Lulu Wu, our senior designer.
How are you? Hello, everyone.
Welcome to Sublime Interiors, Ms. Chen.
Yeah.
Please, have a seat. Today, we'd just like to see what new curtain materials you have.
Okay, it's my pleasure, Mr. Hudson.These curtain samples are Italian imports. handcrafted high end.
Thank you.
What great texture, and the colors are so vibrant.
I thought you might like them.
These are silk, aren't they?
Yes, pure Thai silk.
What about price?
Price is always negotiable, but we need to take a closer look at these samples first. Then we can talk price.
Please take your time.
Now, we don't have the subtitles for you, and that is by design, that is on purpose. We just want you to look and listen the first time. Now we will, not right now, but soon we will take a look at the words and phrases, and then you can look at it a second time. This forces you to focus or concentrate on your work. But let's take a short break before we get busy again.Now we're ready for part three, words and phrases, the vocabulary part of our lesson. Etiquette, etiquette.
礼仪
By observing and following their social rules of etiquette,We will more easily be accepted by foreign friends.
透过观察并依循他们的社交礼仪，外国的朋友会比较容易接纳我们。
Link, link.
联系。
These two companies have done business together for many years. Their link is very strong.
这两家公司已经合作许多年了，他们之间的联系非常的强。
Notice in your textbook that we have link and then noun, and that usually means it can be used in other ways as well. Link can also be used as a verb. To link means to join things or to put things together.
嗯，好，所以这里补充的呢，是我们课本上呢 ，link 后面有一个括号，然后 and 就是指 noun 名词，那表示呢，它当然也有别的词性可以使用。那 link 刚刚 Bruce 老师补充的，也可以当动词来使用，那它指的就是把东西连接在一起。所以刚刚有提到说 to put things together， OK， 这就是 link 的动词。
Right， let's continue. Appointment， appointment，
预约。
My tooth really hurts. I'm going to make an appointment to see my dentist.
我的牙齿很痛，我要赶快跟我的牙医预约看诊。
Representative. Representative.
代表。
I made an appointment with the representative of the moving company to look over my apartment and give me an estimate.
我跟搬家公司的代表预约了时间来看我的公寓，并且帮我估个价。
Notice the last word here is pronounced estimate. As a verb, the same word is pronounced estimate. I've mentioned this many times before during book one, and we'll see this again many times. A-T-E, 字尾的字 in English. Noun or adjective, it.念 it. If, however, it's used as a verb, change it to ate. I have an estimate of how many people will go to his party. I estimate 20 people will go to his party.
Okay.这是一个非常好的重点哦，所以呢，这个 Bruce 老师提醒大家，遇到了 ate 结尾的单字，记得当它是用名词或形容词的时候呢，它的发音是 it， 可是呢，当你变成 verb 动词的时候，它是 it 这样子的一个方式。那我们看到的这个 estimate 或 estimate 这个字，就是一个很好的 sample。
Right. Okay. Next item number five. cubicle, cubicle.
办公空间。
In my cubicle at work, there is only enough room for a desk, chair, and of course, my coffee mug.
在我的办公空间只足够放桌子、椅子和我的咖啡杯。
Sublime, sublime.
卓越的。
Katsuo's cooking is sublime. I don't know anyone who doesn't enjoy it.
一夫的厨艺很卓越，我不认识任何一个人是不喜欢他的料理的。
Line, line.
款式。
Paul works in the retail clothing industry. In his line of work, the competition is fierce.
保罗从事休闲服饰的生产，这个款式的竞争相当激烈。
Line is a good example of one of those words that has completely different meanings, or at least it doesn't seem they have any relationship at first. A line, if you take your pen, this beautiful pen,You can draw a line, but we also use it metaphorically to represent a group of similar items, a line of products.
Okay, 然后呢，除了刚刚Bruce老师讲的用那支很普通的笔可以画一条 line 直线，或者是 a line of 指的就是一个系列的什么， and we can also use line up.
That's right.
排队。
Yeah, standing in line.So it has many uses. Get used to this.
And there's one use that I bet you don't know. What does it mean when people ask you, do you use line? And that is...
What's your line, you mean?
No, do you use line? That's a mobile phone chatting application right now.
You're right. I didn't know that.
我是故意的。OK, 所以呢，这个倒也是现在可能同学反而更常用，就是那个手机上的 line 哦。那不过呢，那个 line 比较对考试没有那么有帮助。刚刚讲的这几个 line 比较重要，请把它记下来。OK.
Right. Next item. Curtain. Curtain.
窗帘。
The sun is shining into the room.It's getting hot in here.
So, close the curtains, lazy bones. 阳光照进房间里，开始变热了啦。所以呢，你就拉上窗帘啊，懒骨头。
Contact. Contact.
联络。
When writing a business letter, be sure to provide your contact telephone number and email address.
撰写工作往来的书信时，记得要提供联络的电话号码和电子信箱。
Greet, greet.
接待，打招呼。
When walking down the street, Lyle is accustomed to greeting people with a nod and a hello.
莱尔走在街上的时候，都习惯会对行人点头致意，然后说声 hello。
Sample, sample.
样本。
Take these samples of kitchenware to the department store.
Right, boss, I'm on it. 把这些厨房用具的样本拿到百货公司去。是的，老板，我马上去。
Introduce, introduce.
介绍。
When introducing yourself,Always look the other person in the eye, smile, and speak clearly.
在自我介绍的时候，要记得看着对方的眼睛，微笑，然后清楚地讲话。
Senior, senior.
资深。
Annette has worked in our office the longest, so she is senior to everyone else.
安妮塔在我们的公司服务最久，所以她比大家都资深。
It's my pleasure. It's my pleasure.
这是我的荣幸。
Would you make some cookies for my friends and me, Mom?
It's my pleasure. You know how much I love to bake. 妈，你可以帮我和朋友们烤些饼干吗？哦，这是我的荣幸啊！你知道我有多喜欢烘焙的。
Catalog. Catalog.
行路。
This year's fall catalog of women's fashions has high quality and interesting pictures of beautiful models.
今年女装的秋季行路品质很高，有很多美丽的模特儿和有趣的照片。
In your textbook, you might notice that this is one of the words in English that has more than one way to spell it. So catalog can be homian O-G or O-G-U-E, 都可以。
嗯哼，所以这个同学可以稍微做个记号 ,OK?
And let's continue. Staff. Staff.
职员。
We have a staff of 20 at our downtown airline office waiting to serve the public.
我们航空公司在市区的服务中心有20名的职员来服务民众。
A word about this word.Staff is a group noun. It refers to a group of people. If you want to talk about one person on your staff, the best way to say it would be a member, two members, five members of our staff. 口语的话, many people use staffer, but this is not considered formal usage.
好，所以这里很重要的就是刚刚讲到的这种 staff 职员，它是一个集合名词，所以它指的是全体的职员，而不是一个职员、两个职员。那当同学们你要表示五个职员的时候呢，就像刚刚 Bruce 老师讲的，请你用 five members of our staff，这时候你就是指我们职员当中的五位，那你就可以用单复数去表示了。
Okay, number 17. Present.Present.
在场。
The PE teacher counted 28 of his students present with 2 absent.
体育老师点名有28名学生在场，2名缺席。
Import. Import.
进口。
As the value of a country's money increases,The cost of imports from other countries decreases.
当一个国家的货币增值的时候，从其他国家进口的价格就会下降。
Handcrafted. Handcrafted.
手工。
These wooden statues from Indonesia are handcrafted by men who have worked their entire lives at this art form.
这些木雕是由印尼那些奉献了他们一生来雕刻的艺术家们所手工制成的。
High end, high end.
高级。
I can't afford to buy anything in this high-end department store, but I can enjoy just looking around.
我虽然买不起这家高级百货公司的任何商品，但我可以享受在这里逛街的感觉。
Texture, texture,
材质。
The tailor is so knowledgeable and experienced with materials that he can tell you a kind of material just by feeling its texture.
这位裁缝十分的有专业知识和经验，只要触摸布料，他就可以告诉你它的材质。
Okay, I have to point out here, page 19 at the top. The sentence ends with "in your book" by just feeling it, but we don't have the word texture, so we should have by just feeling its its ja texture.
That's right. 所以这里呢，少打了这个材质的部分，所以 its 这个 it 要加一个 s， 就是它的后面再来接 texture 就对了。
All right, let's finish our last few words now. Vibrant. vibrant.
鲜明的。
The bright sunlight at noon made all the colors in the forest vibrant.
正中午的艳阳让森林里的颜色显得鲜活。
Silk, silk.
丝。
Made from an insect, silk has been a valuable material in East and Southeast Asia for thousands of years.
几千年来，由蚕所制造出来的丝，在东亚和东南亚都十分有价值。
Thai, Thai.
泰国的。
Thai food can be very spicy, so be careful when you order Thai dishes in a restaurant.
泰式料理很辣，所以在餐厅点餐时要小心。
As we always do, we take a short break before we finish the lesson. Now we're ready for part four, an extra serving. I want to remind you that it's workbook time again, because if you do read the lesson and the two exercises at the end of that lesson, you will learn a lot more about Western business etiquette.
所以呢，本周的资讯补给站呢，大家一定要读，尤其是你的工作上，如果未来跟西方人有一些社交的需要，还有一些工作礼仪上的增强，都非常非常的有用。
All right, now let's take a look at our quiz. Part five quiz.This week, we have a closed dialogue for you. And if you have your textbook handy, and maybe you should for each of these lessons, you can see it's a dialogue, but some of the words are missing. There are words below the dialogue, which you should choose from and put them into the appropriate places or spaces or blanks throughout the dialogue.I'm just going to read through this and provide the correct answers for you. Sanford and a doctor are going to have this dialogue. Sanford is a salesman for a drug company, and Dr. Randolph is a doctor.
Okay, 所以我们呢，这个对话的情境呢，是 Sanford 他是一家药厂的业务代表，那他呢去拜访了这个 Dr. Randolph， 因为要给他看一种这个刚研发出来的新药。
Okay, the salesman begins the dialogue. Good afternoon, Dr. Randolph. I'm Sanford Brown, a sales representative from Purity Drugs Company. The doctor says, yes, you made an appointment with me on the phone yesterday. Then Sanford says, I'd like to introduce a new drug our company has developed. We call it Lightweight.Because it helps the overweight to diet more successfully. Then the doctor asks, has it been tested thoroughly? And Sanford answers him, yes, and we have government approval for it. It's been shown to be completely safe. The doctor says, it sounds interesting. Can you leave me more information about it? Sanford says, sure.Here's a catalog of all our drug products, and I'll leave you with a supply of lightweight samples, too. And the doctor thanks him.
Okay, 所以呢，我们来看到呢，这个这里的五个题目。首先呢，第一个的答案呢是 made an appointment， 就是刚刚讲到的，我们是约会。约一个时间见面叫做 made an appointment.
Make an appointment.
That's right. 那 number two 呢我们看到是 I'd like to, 这里是要 introduce, 我要来介绍一下我们的这个新药、哦、业务代表就是要做这个事情的。那第三题呢、我们可以看到的 we have government approval, 这是指政府的许可的意思。那么第四个呢 here's a catalog, 通常你会给人家看行录、哦、所以呢他要留下一个行录给他。还会给他一个什么呢？就是我们讲 a supply of lightweight samples， 就是样本。OK。
That's it. That's very good. All right. We're ready now to take our second look at today's dialogue.
Chen, may I help you?
I'd like to speak with Alice Chen, please.
Speaking.
Good morning. I'm Betty Hudson at Sublime Interiors. We received your email and we'd like to invite you to show your new line of curtain materials. What time would be convenient for you?
I'm available this afternoon or tomorrow morning, if that's convenient for you.
This afternoon would be better. We have a meeting here tomorrow morning.
How about 3 o'clock? I already have all the materials you mentioned ready to show.
That would be great. Then we'll see you at 3 o'clock. Your company has our address and contact phone numbers, but I can send them to you again if you like.
That's not necessary. We're on your supply interiors. I will see you at 3.
Bye.
Bye. Materials is ready for Dai Chen.
Oh.
Is Miss Hudson here?
I am Betty Hudson.
Oh,
and call me Betty.
And please call me Alice.
Okay, we are already in the meeting room. Please follow me and let me help you with your samples.
Thanks, Betty.
Here. Allow me to introduce Alice Chen to you all. Okay. This is Ed Hudson, our company boss. Next to him is George Hong, our sales supervisor. And next to him is Lulu Wu, our senior designer.
How are you? Hello, everyone.
Welcome to Sublime Interiors, Ms. Chen.
Yeah.
Please, have a seat. Today, we'd just like to see what new curtain materials you have.
Okay, it's my pleasure, Mr. Hudson. These curtain samples are Italian imports, handcrafted high-end.
Thank you.
Ooh, what great texture. And the colors are so vibrant.
I thought you might like them.
These are silk onlay?
Yes, pure Thai silk.
What about price?
Price is always negotiable, but we need to take a closer look at these samples first. Then we can talk price.
Please take your time.
Well, that's it for today's lesson. I'm going to give you a sneak preview. Next week, we have still another meeting, but this time it's a really, really important one. Every company has one, and many families as well. It's a budget meeting, so you've got to join us next week.
好 ，Bruce 老师提醒大家呢，偷偷的预告下个礼拜要开的那个会议是对所有的人都非常重要的，叫预算会议哦，所以千万不要错过哦。
That's right. Make sure you're here with us. We're always happy to have you with us. Till then, bye-bye.